Hi, and welcome to this tutorial on SpeedLegal. The first thing to do is to upload your contracts into SpeedLegal. At the top of the table, you will see the uploader zone. With the limitation that we currently support, we support PDFs and soon Word documents up to 10 megabytes. And here, you will see the list of contracts that we currently support, the types of contracts. So I'm going to go on and upload one of my contracts from my library, from my folder. Great, now SpeedLegal is processing my contracts. In a couple of minutes, even less, we'll get back to you with a notification telling you what to do next. Great, SpeedLegal sent me a notification telling me that there is an action needed. By clicking here, I see SpeedLegal will be comparing my contract to the standard. In this case, it's SpeedLegal license on-premise market standard. If I had uploaded a contract, a standard, a benchmark, a template, I could use that as a comparison benchmark. I also see the cost of reviewing this contract with AI. If I have a subscription, the cost may go down and it may be very cheap to review. Once I'm ready, I confirm and proceed. Perfect. Now it's gonna take a couple of minutes for SpeedLegal to review the contract and give me the report. And now the contract is ready. The status turns blue and I just click on the contract to see the results. Now, let's review a contract with SpeedLegal. I'm going to use a contract that you all have, a sample contract in your account, a data processing agreement. The first thing I'm going to notice is the total risk at the top right corner, the exposure, compared to the market standard, SpeedLegal market standard, or to the internal playbook, my internal standard. SpeedLegal breaks it down into red flags, missing criteria, and green flags. Red flags are deviations or mismatches compared to the market standard, any concept mismatching the standard. Missing criteria are all the concepts that SpeedLegal has found that are not present in the standard. So these are good suggestions to improve my contract and to potentially draft a new contract in case I want to upload an almost empty contract. Green flags are the good things, thumbs up, those things that are matching my standard. For example, starting from the top, I see that the scope purpose of the processing, the language is not aligned with my market standard. So I can accept what SpeedLegal is suggesting, or I can dismiss those suggestions. I can also create variations of that suggestion by refreshing the suggestion. The AI will create a new text that can I review and then approve into a new change. If I like it, I can go on and accept. I can also add specific text to this suggestion. When I save it, I'll be able to see it directly into my contract here on the left. The I button on the right, top right corner of each card tells me as a user, why is this concept closed and provision relevant to me? For example, here, subprocessor, prior authorization, this clause serves to facilitate efficient and effective data processing operations by providing the processor with the necessary authority to engage with the processor. So this is important that I added, and that's the reason why. What are those scores that you see at the bottom right in green? Those are how much each concept, each improvement, will impact the total score. So if I accept this specific concept, it will decrease the risk and exposure by 3%. Now, let's say that I want to personalize the results to my own needs. By clicking here on the right side, select standard, I can customize the standard of comparison, the benchmark, by either uploading my own standard. Let's imagine I found a contract online on a reputed website, or I have a very good template that I've developed with my attorney. I can upload it directly using this button on the top right, the upload standard, via CSV and PDF very soon format. Or I can start modifying SpeedLegal standard for my own needs. For example, I know that rental agreements, in my case, the base rent has a specific amount. By clicking on edit, I'd be able to add the base rent of my apartment and making sure that the new contracts will be compare it with my own standard. So I click save. I can adjust the terms. For example, I can say the basic term is 2 years or 1 year lease rental for this property, and I can adjust the jurisdiction here to California. Once I'm done, I accept and I save the changes and I call it HPP Rental Standard B1. I submit and this will be saved here. So when I go back to my rental agreement, this is my lease agreement for example, I'll be able to go back on the select standard and see the HPP Rental V1. I will click on this and SpeedLegal will tell me, do you want to review it versus your standard? Great. This is the cost, confirm and proceed, and it will start review for you. Another powerful functionality of SpeedLegal is called Ask Our AI. Before starting the negotiation or before talking to your attorney, Ask Our AI will help you to be prepared for that conversation and clearly understanding exactly what you're about to discuss. So you can save time and money on that process, on that negotiation, on that discussion with your lawyer. If you click on Ask Our AI on the top side of your screen, you will see some suggested questions that our legal team has already prepared for you, the most frequently asked questions. By clicking on any questions, you'll get the answers. If we find an answer, we tell you where it is in the contract. If we don't find an answer, we tell you it's not present to avoid hallucination. So this is super relevant to clearly understand exactly what you're signing. And you can ask any question, for example, is this compliant with GDPR? Here, we found an answer and we tell you where it is. So you can double check if the AI is actually telling the truth or not. Again, this feature is super useful if you really want to understand what the contract entails. Another super useful part of SpeedLegal is really understanding what's in the contract in a blink. It's called contract summary. By clicking here, you'll see what are the parties involved, which jurisdiction and governing law are currently involved in this contract. And this is super easy because I just need to click a button and I will see it right away. The effective date of the contract, any financial terms, the length of the contract, the termination, the payment terms, if there is any attachment or exhibit, super fast. I'll be able to also set reminders for my renewals and termination of my contracts. So now I've reviewed the contract with SpeedLegal, I've clearly understood what I'm about to sign, I'm ready to export the results into a Word Redline version of my contract. By clicking on export, I'll be able to see the contract automatically redlined by SpeedLegal, written in the same formatting of my inputted contract, and with the track changes, I'll be able to share it so that the party will be able to send it back. I will upload it in SpeedLegal, do the review, export the Word again for speedy and fast negotiations. And this is seamlessly integrated with Word documents.